Hi, welcome to Live, Learn, and Grow, another episode. So I hope you enjoyed the last episode about the conversation that we had with the woman with the relationship that didn't work out. So which pondered me, I was pondering why relationships don't work out and doing some research as to why relationships don't work. Well, there's a lot of reasons why relationships don't work, but I want to just focus on one or two issues. Welcome, we're outside today. It's a beautiful day. I have no allergies. So it's just, I'm so grateful to be able to be outside and enjoy the birds. I hope you can hear the birds and every once in a while they'll just come and gather around, and especially the colorful birds. They seem to love me so much, and I believe those are my mother, my grandmother, my grandfather, my husband looking over me, because sometimes the cardinals would just sit, there'd be three of them, and they'd just sit on my fence, and they'll look up right at my bedroom window, and they'll just start talking to me. And I know that those are my spirit guardians, guiding me and protecting me and sending me messages from our Father in Heaven. So I want to talk about relationships. One of the things about relationships that I notice is that when women get together and they're talking about their relationships, they never focus on themselves. All the focus is on the man, what he did, what he don't do, what he should be doing. You see, that is the number one reason that I feel, in my opinion, and opinions again is just like belly buttons, everybody got one, but I feel that this is why we don't grow from stagnant relationships that get stuck, because we get stuck in focusing all of our attention on what the guy is doing or what the girl is doing if you're in that relationship. So here's what I've learned, and I want to spit this out to you, is that that creates stuckness in your relationship. When you come into a relationship, it's you and that person, okay? But you have to remain your person. You have to find your real self in the relationship. And because a breakup is never one-sided, it's always two-sided, you have to focus on who you are and what you bring to the table. And some of us is bringing the whole table and getting in relationship with people that don't even have the legs to pull, to sit, to help the table stand up. And now that's a whole nother conversation. But on this conversation, I want to focus on being yourself in the relationship and keeping track of your life plan. You see, everybody should have a life plan, and a life plan can continue to, you continue to work on it. You may have to tweak it, okay? But you have to, in your relationship, you can't let that person stop you from doing what you were doing when you met them. That person that comes in your life is supposed to be lifting you up. Like I said, if you brought the table, he should bring the legs. So he is holding you up, and she is, you know, holding you up and bringing something to you. Every relationship should be bringing something to help you grow. So if you are in a relationship and you are only focusing on what the person's bad behavior, okay, that means you are stuck. And a lot of times we get stuck is because we have bad family connections. We have families that are, you can see the leaves falling down, aren't they just so beautiful? Some, you know, we have family connections that are not even, they're not even connected. They're distanced. I was going over my my genogram, and what I discovered is that everybody in my family is distant. If they keep secrets, they don't want to talk to, they don't want to talk about things. They don't want to get together because fear that somebody may burst out and want to bring up something from the past to help them grow. A lot of people live in families like this. I posted on Facebook about why is relationships between daughters and mothers so difficult. And do you know that everybody that responded to my Facebook page was family members? See, these are some of the things you have to look at in your family. There are things like, all of these women that responded, oh, I wish I had a better relationship with my daughter. That is a theme in our family, that mothers don't have good relationships with their daughter. And when I go back in my genogram, I can see that my mother didn't have a good relationship with her mother, that my grandmother didn't have a good relationship with her grandmother. And you can see threads that's in your tapestry. You can see the different threads that come from the family. And here's the thing, the camera is falling, so let's try to get it back upright. So, and here's the thing, so you can't move forward until you go backwards. Mental illness, you have to go back and see where that mental illness started from in your family so that you can correct that. My husband, let me tell you this, he always said that he was gonna die at 50. Because every man in his family died at 50. So we have to be aware of those are triggers. There's a very much trigger. So when he turned 50, that was a big trigger for him. And the anxiety and the stress caused him to have a heart attack, thus fulfilling the prophecy that no man lives in his family past 50. Because when you listen to these tales in the family and you believe these tales, then self-fulfilled prophecy will make these tales happen in the case of my dad. And like in our family, we had this tale that I refused. I told my nieces and I told everybody, I said, no, from this moment on, we're not believing this story anymore. We're not making this a part of our tapestry. We are pulling that thread out, because I did my genogram and realized where that thread came from. So I'm pulling that thread out, and I tell my nieces and my nephews, we are no longer believing that lie. We are not a cursed generation. We are not cursed. We are children of God. We are designed to have good, healthy marriages. Okay, but if you believe that somebody put a curse on your family a long time ago and that nobody stays married, which was the thing in our family, that was the thread that was going through our family, and consequently, you know, people was dying, people was getting divorced, and people was breaking up, and nobody just had no happiness in their marriage because of that thread that everybody believed. Okay, so for instance, if you believe that, so for instance, my stepson died when he was 13 years old in October. And so every October, you know, my husband would go through, a whole depression thing. And then when our child got 13, he went through a whole depression thing again because he thought that he was gonna lose this child at 13. So these are triggers that trigger us in life that, and in relationships, when you don't know the triggers and you don't tell somebody about the triggers so they can help you through this rough time to get over this hurdle, to get over that day, that memory, that thing that you think is going to happen, it creates a problem in your relationship because you become withdrawn from your partner and your partner has no idea why. And so your partner may think you're just being passive aggressive, or you may be showing some narcissistic behavior, but in reality, you're dealing with a trigger date, you're dealing with a trigger disease, you're dealing with something. And so these are some of the reasons why relationships don't work, because there's no open communication around these trigger parts. Okay, so this is the takeaway that I want you to take away from this conversation today. It's short and sweet, that focus when you're in a relationship, don't focus on what he's doing terrible, don't focus on his whatever it is, I don't care if it's bad breath, don't even focus on the bad breath. Focus on you. Keep your focus on you, and keep building up yourself, and you keep working on yourself and doing your shadow work. This is what I call the shadow work. When you go in and you find out what's driving a certain situation, if you have a pattern in your life that you pick up the same type of people all the time, you have to go back into your generational, into your background, and find out where did that come from. Somebody in your past didn't have high self-esteem, and so they were taking out trash, okay? And then you grew up seeing your parents or your significant person who raised you going after people that wasn't worth even going after, And then when you become grown up, you start doing the same thing, and you don't even know that you're doing it because this is what you saw growing up, okay? And once you realize what you saw growing up, you are not that person. You don't have to be that person who you grew up. You could be another person, but you can't be that person unless the work is done, okay? I grew up in a neighborhood where there was hoes and hustlers, okay? And that's what I seen, okay? That's not who I am. That doesn't make me. Okay, so at some point I had to realize in my life, look, you are not that person. You are not your neighborhood. You are not the product of your neighborhood. You can be whatever you want to be. You can change these patterns. And is it hard? Is it hard to change? Oh, hell yeah. Patterns are so hard to change. But you can't change the pattern unless you recognize the pattern. And then once you recognize the pattern, when you get so sick and tired and sick and tired of your life going the way it's going, and you need to make a turn, there's only one way to make that turn. You have to surrender that old you, that old pattern. You have to surrender that to God, and you have to have to God, make me all over from the inside out. That is the only way. If you grew up with them in a family that was all hectic and screaming and hollering and beating and father beating, chances are you're going to grow up and be in relationships with that. But that's not who you are. At any time, you can change that pattern. At any time, you can pull that thread out of your family history, out of your family tapestry, and you can make it new for the next generation. Because trust me, your little girls are watching you. Your little boys are watching you. Your behavior teaches them how they are supposed to behave. And then when they get stuck in these same ruts that you are stuck in, you and I are stuck in, they get stuck in these same ruts, but see, nobody talks about it, so nobody's there to help that child get out of that rut. Families have to start talking about, you know, when I grew up, so that the people, that the child can connect and say, I'm going to pull that thread. I'm not going to be a part of that. That's not going to be a part of my history anymore, because I'm better than that. I don't have to marry an alcoholic. I don't have to be involved with men that beat me. I don't have to be involved with women that have bipolar, manic depressive, borderline personality, schizophrenic. You don't have to be involved with people like that, because you have the ability to, when your ancestors open up and talk, and it is your job to get them to talk at family reunions, you'd say, hey, auntie, tell me about this or tell me about that, okay? So that you know where that came from and that you don't have to be that person. Rip it, like Medea said when she went to that closet when her niece, when the guy was dogging her niece, she said, rip it, rip it, rip it. Okay, you gotta rip that from your life, and you have to start all over, because this is what I've learned this week. God cannot put in new wine in old skin. You have to get a new skin so that God can pour in new wine. You don't have to be your mother. You don't have to be your father. You don't have to say, well, you know, my family been like this for years and that's just the way it is. Rip it. Rip it out. Okay? So, hey, I'm your girl, Betty. I hope this was helpful. This is a great book. It's called The Dance of Intimacy. I can't remember the author right now, but I'll put the link in the bottom of the... I'll put the link in the bottom so you can get that book. It's an excellent book. I recommend this book to start charting your genogram and to start learning where those behaviors came from and how you can rip them. So hit this notification button, hit the subscribe button, and y'all be blessed. Bye.